One last time, make sure there's nothing binding here. Crank down on it. A little tight on the black wire coming off the motor. I'm gonna do a slight adjustment on it. Don't want anything pinched. Good. Don't have a screw there yet. Thank you. also route the T-plug wires through the little clip they have in there. That will make sure that the heat sink for the ESC doesn't have anything going on over it, and that fan will keep it nice and cool. I believe it's the same ESC they use on the 12th scale with the 390 motor, so probably gets a lot hotter with this 490 motor. These crank down, we'll check and make sure the diffs are spinning freely before we go any further. So even though everything's metal and brand new, still check and make sure we don't have any backlash. Plastic or metal, that backlash will destroy your gears quick. It's opened. I'm gonna check the three screws that tighten down the steering servo, which all three of them. Also, I got a quarter turn out of. Get this through that clip. Plug wires. Thank you. of the screwdriver that comes with the car. Comes in the box. Differentials. The rear spins nicely. And the front is spinning also. Same thing with the front. Alright. I left the screws in this one. In it to line up with the other section before the screws go in. Be careful not to pinch the plug wires. Take them out to get the clip back in. We'll try it this way first. Out. can't let go. Sitting there also. Tighten these up. Twins like driving at night, you definitely need those. Let's do these screws in a star pattern. As close to as possible. Tight since we're screwing into plastic. Would improve on is if they'd leave the LED light on for about 30 seconds after you spin it in either direction. I think it only has 1.5 inch-foot-pounds of torque, which is not much. Perfect for working on electronics. Small stuff like this without stripping it out. Everything's black. A little extra light would be nice. So far, give it a quarter turn by hand if needed. Found two that I missed. Right above the drive shaft gear and the motor pendant. Dog bones out. Need to go ahead and put those in before I mount the upper control arms back to the shock towers. Differential case screws on front and back. Leave them loose to be able to bend the bumper down. Sides. Okay. Change our bit out. This Phillips is a little bit larger. Put in our screws for the bones that'll pop out when you do that. Two screws for that differential case. They are a little bit longer than all the other ones because they also go through the bumper mount. These are torqued properly. This is where all the sealed bearings are. Any vibration in there. All the gears will mesh properly. Attach the two shocks. Two positions here. I'm putting it back in the one it was in because between the foam filled tires and the suspension on this truck, it felt great the way it